हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेवंश फ्रॉम डीजी इंटीग्रिटी। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज एपिसोड 70। एप्पल रिसेंटली टफेंड इट्स प्राइवेसी फीचर विद द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ iOS 14.5 व्हिच मेक्स ऐप ट्रैकिंग जस्ट एन ऑप्शन, यूजर्स कैन ऑप्ट ऑफ इट। हाउएवर, फेसबुक इज हेल बेंट ऑफ कन्विंसिंग पीपल एज टू व्हाई दे शुड लेट इट कलेक्ट देयर डेटा। बोथ फेसबुक एंड इंस्टाग्राम हैव स्टार्टेड शोइंग पॉपअप्स टू iOS यूजर्स विद अ नेम टू सेल देम द आइडिया ऑफ ऐप ट्रैकिंग बट विद अ ट्वीट। हियर्स व्हाट इज ऑल अबाउट। एज रिवील्ड द टेक्नोलॉजी रिसर्चर, द नोटिसेस सेंट बाय फेसबुक एंड इंस्टाग्राम प्रोवाइड्स पीपल विद मोर इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑन पर्सनलाइज्ड ads. However, this very concept helps Facebook free of charge. Lenovo recently held the Yoga X Xeoxing Spring product launch event in China, where a series of products were released. Apart from the array of notebooks that made their entry, the company also launched a number of accessories. One of them is a Yoga CC65 dual-port GaN charger. Lenovo has now silently unveiled a high model dubbed the Yoga CC130 charger. It was revealed last week that Motorola's upcoming H-branded smartphones are codenamed as Syra, Berlin, Berlin NA and Kyoto. German publication recently shared the camera specification of Kyoto handset. The publication is now back with camera configuration of the Berlin model. The new report reveals that the Berlin and Berliner NA smartphones will be sporting a 32-megapixel OmniVision front-facing camera. Both handsets will come equipped with a 108-megapixel rear-facing triple camera system. Realme RMX 3231 has appeared on Geekbench with key specifications. Realme C11 2021 is expected to launch in India soon. Realme C11 will come with a 2GB of RAM and it comes on Android 11. The Realme C11 sport a 6.5-inch water drop notch display with a HD+ resolution. The smartphone will be powered by the MediaTek Helio G35 chipset paired with 2GB of RAM and 32GB of internal storage. Realme C1 packs a 5000mAh battery and supports a standard 10W charge. Realme C20A launch date is expected to release around 12th of this month. The phone will make its debut in Bangladesh. Key specifications include a 6.5-inch display and a 5000mAh battery. Hopefully, we will get to know more about the device as its launch nears. It is also worth mentioning that there is no news regarding the Realme C20A launch date in India. Samsung is developing firmware for the Indian variant of Galaxy A52 5G. Samsung Galaxy A52 5G price in India could be between 26,499 and ₹34,999. Key specifications include a 6.5-inch 120Hz AMOLED display with Snapdragon 750G processor and a 64-megapixel quad camera, and we can also see 4,500mAh battery in it. The tweet claims that the model number of the Galaxy A52 5G that will launch in India is SM-A52-6B. It is the same model number that belongs to the Galaxy A52 5G that is sold in international market. It means that Galaxy A52 5G will be launching in India will have the same specifications as an international model. Samsung Galaxy A82 5G has been listed on the Galaxy Update Tracking website. The handset is speculated to be a rebrand of the Galaxy Quantum 2. Key specifications include a 6.7-inch OLED display, Snapdragon 855+ processor and a 64-megapixel camera, and we can also see 6GB of RAM and 128GB of internal storage. While the battery capacity is unknown to the phone, will get a 15W fast charging support. Samsung Galaxy Tab A7 Lite support page have gone live on the Samsung India website. The tablet could be available in both Wi-Fi only and LTE models. Samsung Galaxy Tab A7 Lite comes with a 9.7-inch display, 5100mAh battery and a 15W fast charging support. And it is also powered by Qualcomm Snapdragon 662 paired with Adreno 610 GPU. It comes with a 3GB of RAM and 32GB of internal storage, and that is further expandable up to 1TB via microSD card. The tablet run Android 10 OS with One UI custom skin on top. As of cameras, the Samsung Galaxy Tab A7 has an 8-megapixel sensor on the back. And a 5-megapixel sharper on the front for selfies and video chats. It packs with a 7040mAh battery and features a Knox security system to keep the data safe. The company has formed a partnership with Discord, an instant messaging platform. The company will integrate the service into its PlayStation platform. Sony has also invested an undisclosed amount into the service. Under this collaboration, Sony will work towards integrating Discord into its PlayStation platform to enable its users to socialize on the messaging service. Huawei has recently been rolling out the developer public beta version of its Harmony OS to select smartphone models. Now the company has announced that it is gearing up for the launch of its proprietary operating system's final build that will launch sometime in early June 2021. The president of the Chinese tech giant Consumer Business Software Development and the director of AI and Smart Business Department, the company will be rolling out the Harmony OS update from the beginning of June. While the senior executive refrained from announcing the names of the specific models that would receive this upgrade, it is expected that the Mate 40 series, Mate 30 series and P40 series and Mate X2 series will be the one of the first to receive this update. The highly anticipated Huawei P50 series is expected to launch next month. The latest is Huawei's popular P series of smartphone that had its launch delayed due to multiple reasons, chief of them being supply chain issues. While we wait for an official release date, we have got our hands on altered renders of the Huawei P50 that were provided to us by a KS manufacturer. These renders show us the Huawei P50 will be going for a new look entirely different from that as a predecessor. Huawei P40 and even Mate 40 that launched last year, the design matches that we have seen from earlier leaks such as CAD renders that released by OnLeaks back in March. Infinix announced the Infinix Hot 10S and the Hot 10S NFC in the Indonesian market a few days back. Now it looks like the company is preparing up to bring the Infinix Hot 10S to the Indian market soon. The Infinix will be launching the Hot 10S in India in the second week of May. The company says that this device will come with a smooth display, classy design, high gaming performance and a superior camera. To recall, the Infinix 10S features a 6.8-inch HD plus 90Hz display and it is powered by a Helio G85 processor. The phone ships with up to a 6GB of RAM and it is backed by a massive 6000mAh battery. Bill Gates says that COVID-19 vaccine tech should not be shared with India now there is a vaccine shortage. In a recent interview, Bill Gates commented that a technology transfer of vaccine should not be considered due to some challenges. His claims, however, do not fit with the realities and needs of the world. Gates also said that a technology or recipe transfer of vaccine should not be made to other countries. He cited it as a big challenge that has never been done before. He also mentioned vaccine trials as a reason for avoiding this transfer. TikTok's interim head Vanessa Pappas will be the new chief operating officer. Alex Zhu, former TikTok head, had left the role as the company faced scrutiny over the data privacy in 2020. New CEO Chu attended college in London and has an MBA from Harvard. Ullu phone was launched, a brand new night vision camera, highly portable device which works as an accessory to your smartphone, can be used as a wearable body camera that can easily be fitted onto your jacket, belt, back pocket, etc. It features a large pixel size of 2.9mm with a f2.0 large aperture and supports full HD 1080 pixel video recording that enables you to take crystal clear images and videos in a low light environment. Also, with its 116-degree ultra-wide angle camera, you get a significantly expanded view on your surrounding with redundant blind spots, making it perfect for surveillance and security work. India's largest software as a service firm Zoho Corp plans to take its rural-centric development centers model to the United States, the UK, Mexico and Japan to serve local customers, which pioneered the pay-as-you-use software model in India as its main development center in Tenkasi in Tamil Nadu. Envision, a technology company specializing in wind turbine and energy management software, has presented its first ever mobile recharging robot. The new device, which has been christened Muchi, will soon be available to recharge electric vehicles, which are increasingly prevalent in China with 100% green electricity. Dell is to sell its cloud business Bumi to Francisco Partners and TBG for $4 billion. The PC maker is under pressure to boost profitability after its debt-laden acquisition of data storage provider EMC Crop for $67 billion in 2016 failed to meet financial targets hurt by intensifying price competition. Capgemini commits Rs 50 crore to augment medical infrastructure in India. This fund will be used to build COVID care ICU facility, oxygen generation plants and other long-term medical infrastructure and provide relief operations. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.